Welcome you all friends. So today we are going to discuss about Chomsky hierarchy. It simply classifies the languages, a grammar, or we can say a machine. We already I discussed so many times in my videos, but today I just discuss it with the proper name of the topic. It's simply the Chomsky hierarchy. So Chomsky hierarchy is nothing but a neo-Chomsky classify the grammar into four category. So according to the grammar, there is specific grammar, there is a specific language which is generated by that particular grammar, and there is a special machine which simply say that given, we can say, a string or language is present in the particular grammar or not, or particular language or not. So this machine is simply accept or reject, is simply known as a machine or automata, something like that. So here I just have a simple example, or we can say simple diagram, in which you can easily understand the what are the things we till now discussed. So all thing I will show you over here is all discussed already in my previous videos. So today we just simply make a link between them, and what is things belongs to which language or which automata, or we can say which particular grammar. So in the last class, we simply discussed a Turing machine. A Turing machine is simply a machine which contains the tapes and read-write header, or we can say finite control, which having the infinite tape in it. So that is a particular Turing machine. So the machine is a Turing machine, and the language which is simply known as a regular recursively enumerable language, or we can say so a grammar which is unrestricted grammar or type 0 grammar, it generate a language which is known as a regular recursively enumerable language, and the machine which accept this language is known as a Turing machine. So it is a relation like this. So it is a grammar, we can say machine, Turing machine. The language which accepted by Turing machine is known as a regular recursively enumerable grammar and recursively enumerable language, and the language which is generated, the recursive enumerable language, or we can say the grammar which generate a recursive enumerable language, is simply known as the unrestricted grammar. So or so you can say type 0 grammar. Now halting Turing machine, in just previous video we all discussed halting Turing machine. If a particular Turing machine is always halt, or even either in the final state or non-final state, so it's simply known as a halting Turing machine. Why we I take a loop inside a loop, so it is, we can read like in a Venn diagram, we can say like all halting Turing machine are the Turing machine, something like that. So you always say the things like that, all the halting machines are the Turing machine. So it is a subset and it is a superset. So inner circle is always subset, outer circle is a superset. So halting Turing machine is a machine which always halt, and the language which is accepted by this particular halting Turing machine is known as a recursive language. So this topic I already discussed in my previous video. So please watch my all previous video, because each and every machine, language and grammar I already discussed with you. So the machine, halting Turing machine, it accept the language is known as a regular recursive language, and it is also a unrestricted grammar, or you can say type 0 grammar. So it is type 0 grammar, contain the two types of language, a recursive language and recursively enumerable language and recursive language, and the machine are two machine, Turing machine and halting machine. So this two machine, two language are in category of grammar 0, type 0. Now another subset of a particular machine is known as a linear bounded automata. If a Turing machine tape size is limited to the input string size, then that is known as a linear bounded automata. It is also we discussed in our previous video. The language which is accepted by linear automata is simply known as a context sensitive language. We also discuss it. And the grammar which is generate the context sensitive language is known as a context sensitive grammar, or we can say type 1 grammar. So it is also we discuss. So again, the machine is known as a linear bounded automata. The language which is accepted by this machine is known as a context sensitive language, and the grammar which generate a context sensitive language is simply known as a context sensitive grammar or type 1 grammar. Now next is a non deterministic pushdown automata. So pushdown automata simply contains the stack, and it put the inputs stake values or sex symbol, something like that, and it compared the two variables. So for comparing the two variables, we can easily use the push on automata. But non-deterministic, it means for a given input there is a more than one movement, then simply known as a non-deterministic Turing machine. So it is also a subset of linear bounded automata, and it is also a subset of Halting Turing machine and Turing machine. So if we say an NPDA is a LBA, yes, we can say like that. An NPDA, we can say HTML, STM, yes, we can say like that. A non-deterministic push-down automata is also a Turing machine, something like that. So it is a super class, it is a subclass. So every subclass is a super class, but reverse is not possible. Or we can say it is a superset, it is a subset. So every super subset simply resent the superset, but reverse is not possible. I think you understand. So machine which is generated, the machine which is the language which is accepted by the non-deterministic pushdown automata is simply known as a context-free language. So context-free language and the grammar which simply generate the context-free language is known as a context-free grammar and type 2 grammar. Similarly, deterministic pushdown automata, if for a given input there is exactly one output, then we can say, or one movement, then we can say it is a deterministic pushdown automata. Similarly, it is known as a deterministic context-free language. So the language which is accepted by the deterministic pushdown automata is known as a deterministic context-free language. And again, the grammar is same. It is a grammar 2, or we can say context-free grammar. A context-free grammar is common for context-free language or deterministic context-free language, or we can say a machine non-deterministic pushdown automata or deterministic pushdown automata. So it's something like that, Turing machine or Halting Turing machine, something like that, because there is simply one difference, small difference. Now, type 0, type 1, type 2, what is the formation of a particular grammar and what is the types of productions? I each and everything already told you in my previous video. You can please watch all topics, because I already discussed a Turing machine, Halting Turing machine, linear bounded automata, pushdown automata, non-deterministic, deterministic pushdown automata. And the language are recursive language, recursively enumerable language, context sensitive language, context deterministic context free language or context free language, or type 2, type 1 and type 0, all already we are discussed. Now another subset, or we can say a machine, is simply known as a finite automata. And the language which is accepted by this finite automata is simply known as a, we can say, a regular language. And the grammar which is generated by it simply known as a regular grammar or type 3 grammar. So it is this, all classification is simply known as the Chomsky classification or Chomsky hierarchy. So Noam Chomsky simply classify a grammar into the four category. So here is a four category: type 3, type 2, type 1 and type 0. So already we discuss all the four categories, but with the corresponding, a grammar is simply generate a language. If the grammar regular grammar, then it generate a language is known as a regular language, and the regular language is accepted by the finite automata. Similarly, context free grammar generate the language is simply known as a context free language or deterministic context free language, and it is accepted by non-deterministic pushdown automata or deterministic pushdown automata. Similarly, context sensitive grammar is a type 1 grammar, and it generate a language is known as a context sensitive language, and automata which accept this language is known as a linear bounded automata. Similarly, unrestricted grammar or type 0 grammar, it generate a language like a recursive language or recursively enumerable language, and the machine which accept the recursive language is known as a Halting Turing machine, or recursively enumerable language is simply known as a Turing machine. So at this stage, after watching the all video or discussing the all topic, I think you are now capable to understand this diagram. So it is very simple diagram, but it is a very powerful diagram, because it tells so many things in a single diagram. So it is a Chomsky hierarchy. I hope you understand this hierarchy. So friends, thank you very much. If you have any doubts or any question, then please comment your questions. I feel very happy to answer your question. Thank you very much.